What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another exciting Tech Tip Tuesday, and today is all about understanding network terms, and let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to learn is NIC, N-I-C, which stands for Network Interface Card. This basically connects the computer, laptop, or other devices to the network. It is pronounced as NIC, right? Comes in wired or wireless form, and a computer can have multiple NIC within its system, okay? Most likely you would see like a server or a laptop that has like maybe four or two Ethernet ports, right? Now you have LAN, WLAN, or WAN. So LAN stands for local area network. WLAN stands for wireless local area network. WAN basically stands for wide area network. Typically these labels are found within a router or your modem at home. If you take your modem or router or your wireless router and you look behind it, you're going to see like a LAN and a WAN port. That's the way they label it. All right, so some hardware terms that you should know. And this basically consists of a network infrastructure, a router, a gateway, a modem, a hub, and a switch. Now, router or gateway, it's centralized, local to which networking devices are connected to. Routers are normally used within a large network, corporations, big businesses. Gateways are normally used within a small office or a home. Wireless gateways are also known as hub and can also accept wired connections. Routers or gateways can actually manage network traffic, and they can also assign IP addresses to your machines. And depending on what type of router and gateway you have, it could also provide basic network security. Now, a modem. Now, a modem actually connects local networks to the internet, LAN to WAN. Now, a modem can also be a combination of a router or a gateway within a single piece of hardware. Now, hub or switch. Now, a hub or switch actually gives you more wire connections to the network. The way that you connect to your network is either an Ethernet or a Cat5 cable, and then one connection uplinks to the router or gateway, okay? So you always have one link within the hub or switch that goes to your router or gateway, and that link is what gets internet access and provides it to the other ports within the hub or switch. For network protocols, you have Ethernet for wired networks. You have 802.11 for wireless networks. And 802.11 is also broken down by version letters such as 802.11ac. Now, some wireless network terms, you have WDC, which is the wireless distribution system. And this is basically an extended network to be created using wireless access points without traditional wires to link them up, right? Everything is just wireless. And last but not least, you have a mesh network, which is the same thing as your WDS, but it's just more efficient. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this Tech Tip Tuesday. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Don't forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next Tuesday. Peace out.